الحمد لله رب العالمين، صلى الله وسلم على محمد وآله وصحبه وسلم. My dear respected brothers and sisters, I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant you all success to attain the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And from the channels of attaining the pleasure of Allah is to give away fi sabilillah. And rest assured that whatever you give fi sabilillah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward you much more than that. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the meaning of which in Surah Al-Baqarah, Ayah 254, O you who believe, spend of that which we have provided for you before a day comes when there will be no bargaining, no friendship, no intercession. And it is the disbelievers who are the wrongdoers. And he also said, subhanahu wa ta'ala, the meaning of which, the likeness of those who spend their wealth in the way of Allah is as the likeness of a grain of corn. It grows 7 ears, and each ear has 100 grains. Allah gives manifold increase to whom He wills, and Allah is all sufficient for His creatures' needs on nowhere. And they also said in Surah Al-Baqarah, and those who spend their wealth in the cause of Allah and do not follow it up, means their gifts, with the reminders of their generosity or with injury, their reward is with their Lord. On them shall be no fear, nor shall they grieve. And he also says, O you who believe, spend of the good things which you have legally earned, and of that which you have produced from the earth for you, and do not aim at that which is bad to spend from it, though you would not accept it save if you close your eyes and tolerate therein, and know that Allah is rich, free of all needs, and worthy of all praise. Surah Al-Baqarah. And also in the hadith of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, it was narrated that Abu Huraira radiyallahu ta'ala anhu said, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, whoever gives charity equal to a date from good, halal earnings for Allah does not accept anything but that which is good. Allah will take it in His right hand and tend it for the one who gave it, as any one of you tends his fold, until it becomes like a mountain. Narrated by Imam al-Bukhari and Muslim. It was also narrated from Abu Huraira radiyallahu anhu that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, there is no day on which the people get up, but two angels come down. And one of them says, O Allah, give in compensation to the one who spends in charity. And the other one says, O Allah, destroy the one who withholds. Means he does not spend. Narrated by Imam al-Bukhari and Muslim. It was narrated that Abu Sa'id al-Khudri radiyallahu anhu said, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam went out on Eid al-Fitr or Eid al-Adha to the prayer place. And when he had finished the prayer, he preached to the people and enjoined them to give charity. He said, O people, give in charity. Then he went over to the women and said, O women, give in charity, for I have seen that you are the majority of the people of hell. When he went home, Zainab, the wife of Ibn Mas'ud, came seeking permission to see him. It was said, O Messenger of Allah, he said, which Zainab? It was said, the wife of Ibn Mas'ud. He said, yes, let her in. So they let her in. And she said, O Prophet of Allah, sallallahu alayhi wasallam, today you enjoin charity, and I have some jewelry which I wanted to give in charity. But Ibn Mas'ud claims that he and his child have more right to receive it in charity. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, give it in charity to Ibn Mas'ud, for your husband and your child have the most right that you should give it to them in charity. Narrated by Imam Bukhari Muslim. So in this ikhwan, al-ulama, they have taken the ruling that it is permissible to give zakat to your husband or to your wife if they fit that category of needy and poor. It was narrated from Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, Allah said, spend, O son of Adam, and I shall spend on you. Narrated by Al-Bukhari and Muslim. So I ask all the brothers and sisters to help us finish what we have left. So we have about 7 lakh left. So please, give fi sabilillah, for the sake of Allah. Rest assured, it's not going to go to waste. Rest assured. This is going to be a sadaqah jariyah for you, inshallah ta'ala. Imagine, my dear respected brothers and sisters, that when Markaz al-Bayda is established, the land is purchased, and then the building is established there, the masjid is established. Anyone that come to pray there, you will have a reward in that. Anyone who comes there to make wudu, you're going to have a reward. Anyone who picks up a mushaf and read, you're going to have the reward. Imagine how much reward you get. Even when you are not around, when you pass, you still reap the reward. Allahu Akbar. So don't let this opportunity pass you, my dear respected brothers and sisters. Especially in the last 10 days of Ramadan, it can't get any better than this. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us from those who are generous. Those who give fi sabilillah. Walhamdulillah rabbil alameen. Wa sallallahu ala muhammadin wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallim. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.